All right, Tim, thank you very much. And as Tim was just saying, that paperwork error in a state Supreme Court ruling caused hundreds of candidates, mostly challengers, to be disqualified. News 4's Angela Rodriguez is here now with more on how those ousted candidates spent their primary day. What'd they do, Angela?
Well, Gabrielle, they're still campaigning. Only today they're collecting signatures instead of votes, hoping to force their way onto the November ballot.
My name is Frank Taylor. I'm working with Enid Spann. Trying to get him back on the ballot.
All over the upstate, outside polling places, disqualified campaigns are going after signatures because votes won't count.
They really don't understand what has happened. They don't understand why it has happened. We haven't explained what happened, reason why the paperwork was filed incorrectly.
This is for November.
If volunteers can collect the signatures of 5% of the registered voters in their respective districts,
trying to get Enid Spann's name put back on the ballot,
then candidates will be allowed to appear on the November ballot as a nonpartisan candidate.
He had his chances.
It's a struggle for volunteers in every county. A grassroots petition drive launched to overcome a technicality.
Trying to bring fairness back to the process.
Signature here, print your name under it.
In Anderson, the old school approach is slowly working.
I hate to ask you to do it again. I'm Ted Luckadoo.
One handshake at a time, Denny Floyd and Ted Luckadoo are collecting signatures themselves.
We hate we're in this situation, but, you know, we got to do what they ask us to do.
And there's no shortage of voter frustration.
They're blaming the internet for it. That's hogwash. They're making laws so they can be career politicians. I do not believe in career politicians. Career politicians, after they're in there for two terms at the most, like a president, they need to get out and put somebody else in there. They're in there, too comfortable, padding their pockets, need to get out of there.
I'm wanting on the November ballot.
The ballot snafu is unheard of, and for the challengers looking to bring change, it means more work.
Okay. It's like I always told my players, we're not going to quit. We're going to keep going, so we're in overtime now, and that's where we're going to treat it.
The candidates say they have until the middle of July to gather enough signatures. Then elections officials will have to verify it all in order for the candidates to appear on the November ballot as a nonpartisan.